Welcome to the first webinar of our three-part series on behavior analysis and intervention for students in general education, special education, and the 504 program. In this series, we will discuss Tier 1, Tier 2, and Tier 3 behavior interventions, including how to conduct a functional behavior assessment and how to write a behavior intervention plan. Research shows that human success is 20% IQ, or academics, and 80% EQ, or social-emotional. It is imperative that we have both, but the focus for children's success should begin and stay focused on social-emotional and behavior well-being. Here's something to consider. The longer the learning history, the longer it will take to help the child learn new behaviors. The goal is to address the behavior early on in a child's life, with hopes of changing the behavior sooner rather than later. It is also very difficult to try to standardize human behavior, which is why we have to look at all children individually. Let's talk Tier 1. Tier 1 is school-wide and classroom-level supports and interventions. Tier 1 is what the school offers for all students consistently. Every student in the school will receive Tier 1 interventions. Tier 1 includes the following: systems, supports, programs, intervention, data collection, and decision-making throughout the school and classroom. As seen in the pyramid, 80 to 90% of the students campus-wide should be successful with strong Tier 1 supports. The remaining 10 to 20% should be considered for Tier 2 interventions. The systems and practices listed on this slide are examples of positive Tier 1 supports. Generally speaking, campuses and classrooms that maintain systems and supports such as those listed are more likely to see 80 to 90% of their campus population successful with only Tier 1 supports. Remember, for Tier 1 systems and practices to be successful, consistency must be practiced campus-wide. Be sure to emphasize the practices placed in bold. Remember words and phrases such as school-wide positive expectations, routines, consistent, and teaching expected behavior. Is Tier 1 appropriate for my student? Do I need to move to Tier 2 to ensure success for my student? These are common questions that are frequently asked among many staff members. This decision should always be based on data. Review the current data for the student before making a decision to move any student between tiers. When deciding if a student should move tiers, consider the progress or lack of progress the student has made. Consider the following questions. Are the behaviors you desire increasing? Are the behaviors you don't desire decreasing? If the behaviors you desire are increasing and the behaviors you don't desire are decreasing, then remaining at Tier 1 is probably the appropriate decision to make. Always remember, this is about student progress, not perfection. Please remember, whatever tier system you use, or whatever you call it, RTI, MTSS, etc., please remember that the tiers are only used to identify level of support and intervention, not to describe the student. Example, he is a student receiving Tier 2 supports, not he is a Tier 2 student. Even though a student may be at Tier 2 or 3, he or she still receives all supports allowable throughout the preceding tiers. What is next? Well, our webinar series will continue with Part 2, Tier 2 Overview and Supports. For additional questions on Tier 1, please reach out to your regional consultant who provides support in the area of behavior. And finally, our contact information is provided here should you have any additional questions about the information provided. Please feel free to reach out to Lane or Stacy. Thank you.